هذه إلى سبيل الرشاد الموفق لهم في كل شأن إلى سلوك نهج السداد.
سبحان الله.
أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له شهادة من أخذها بيقين فهو في ازدياد.
سبحان الله.
وأشهد أن سيدنا ومولانا محمدا عبده ورسوله سيد السادة الأمجاد. اللهم بارك وصل وسلم عليه وعلى آله وصحبه ومن تبعهم بإحسان إلى يوم البعث والمعاد.
سبحان الله سبحان الله.
أما بعد، فأعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم، بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. ورفعنا لك ذكرك، صدق الله مولانا العظيم. إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي. يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما.
اللهم صل على سيدنا
ومولانا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا ومولانا محمد وبارك وسلم وصلي عليه. صلاة وسلاما عليك سيدي يا رسول الله،
صلى الله
وعلى آلك وأصحابك سيدي يا حبيب الله. مولاي صلي وسلم دائما أبدا على حبيبك خير الخلق كلهم محمد سيد الكونين والثقلين والفريقين من عرب ومن عجم.
سبحان الله.
فاق النبيين في خلق وفي خلق ولم يدالوه في علم ولا كرم. وكلهم من رسول الله ملتمس غرفا من البحر أو رشفا من الديم.
سبحان الله.
ثم الرداء عن أبي بكر وعن عمر وعن عائشة وعن عثمان ذي الكرم.
سبحان الله.
يا رب صل وسلم دائما أبدا على حبيبك خير الخلق كلهم.
سبحان الله.
All praise belongs to Allah سبحانه وتعالى, the creator, the sustainer and the master of the universe. And may countless salutations and incalculable salawat be upon the best of the creation, the leader of all prophets, our master, Sayyidina Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And thereafter, my dearest listeners, I pray Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accepts our gathering here tonight.
Ameen.
And whosoever has contributed and took part in this gathering, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reward them immensely.
Ameen.
And forgive our sins and grant us closeness to himself and his messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. But dear listeners, if you examine the way Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala speaks in the Quran, we see that sometimes Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala uses singular word forms.
Subhanallah.
Using the word of I did such and such, I did so and so, I will do so and so. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala uses singular word form, then that is referring to the oneness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the tawheed, the unity of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And we see in Quran as well, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala uses the plural word form. And what does scholars have mentioned is when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is using the plural word form, that does not mean that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's status gets increased by it or anything of that sort, or that means that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is more than one.
Allah.
That does not mean that. For example, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, and we have sent you not, but has mercy to all of the world.
Subhanallah, subhanallah.
So this is, here is the plural word form used. Similarly, we look at وَرَفَعْنَا لَكَ ذِكْرَكَ. Here as well, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has used the plural word form here. We have elevated your remembrance for you. And so the scholars say that when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala uses the plural word form that we have done such and such, we did this, when he refers with this to an action or a fi'l, then that significance, that sheds light on the significance of that action.
Subhanallah, subhanallah.
And sheds light on the importance of that action.
Subhanallah.
Yani, we elevated your remembrance.
Subhanallah.
This shows when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is using the plural word form, this significate this, you know, this signifies the importance of the zikr and remembrance of Rasulullah.
Subhanallah, subhanallah.
If we look into the explanation of this verse, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, wa rafa'na laka dhikra, we have elevated your remembrance for you, O Beloved sallallahu alayhi wa sallam.
Sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam.
Scholars have said Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, I just said that whenever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, but here it means that whenever I will be remembered, O Beloved, you will be remembered with myself.
Subhanallah, subhanallah.
Yani your remembrance is connected to mine and my remembrance is connected to yours.
Subhanallah.
So yani every time a muazzin will give azan, he will mention the name of Allah.
Subhanallah, subhanallah.
And right next to it and afterwards we remember the name of Rasulullah.
Subhanallah. Nare takbir. Nare risalat. Nare hadri. Nare ghousiya. Fakhre noshahi.
And if you look into the khutbas of Juma, of Eid, whenever the remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is done,
subhanallah,
Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is mentioned right up to it. And this is the significance of the zikr of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Even if an individual believes in the oneness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he believes in the akhirah, he believes that there is a jannah, he believes in nar, the existence of the fire, existence of the gardens, he believes in all of that. He believes in the in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala being the creator of everything. If that person does not believe in the risalah of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the prophethood of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the nubuwwah of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, all everything else does not matter.
Subhanallah.
Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does not accept everything else
Beshak.
If he does not believe in Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, in the nubuwwah of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, we have elevated your remembrance. How has Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala elevated the remembrance of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? We see people say, oh, don't do this, don't say that.
Beshak.
Don't do this, don't mention this, don't mention the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam like this. You know, these kind of things we often hear people mention. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, we have elevated your remembrance. No matter what people say or have said, there will be people who will continuously praise you because it is us who has elevated your
Subhanallah. Allahu Akbar. Ya Rasulullah. Ya Rasulullah. Zindabad.
So the remembrance of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam is elevated when the mu'mineen gather.
Subhanallah.
When the believers gather, they remember Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for blessing them with such a mercy, Rasulullah
sallallahu alayhi wa sallam,
for honoring them with Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And this is something that the ashab of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam also used to do in the lifetime of Rasulullah
sallallahu alayhi wa
sallam. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam once entered into a halaqah of his companions were gathered, and Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam came into that gathering. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam asked the companions, "La ajlasakum?"
Subhanallah.
What is it that gathers you? Why are you gathered here? And the companion said, "That we are gathered here. We are praising Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We are thanking Him for guiding us to this deen of Islam. And the important thing that we need to realize and acknowledge here, that they said we are thanking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for blessing us with yourself.
Subhanallah.
For blessing us with yourself." And so this was something that Ashab of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, this is narrated by Sayyidina Abu Sa'id al-Khudri radiallahu ta'ala, and who reported from Sayyidina Mu'awiyah radiallahu ta'ala. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam asked them, "Do you swear by Allah that there is no other reason for you?"
Allahu Akbar. Allahu Akbar.
The Ashab said, we swear by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that there is no other reason for gathering us today. Nothing else has gathered us. We are only praising Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and thanking Him for guiding us to the deen of Islam.
Subhanallah.
And blessing us with yourself. Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, "I did not ask you to swear or take an oath because I had suspicions or I doubted you or that you had some other reason for gathering. But I only ask you this because Jibreel came to me and informed me that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is mentioning of you all Allah. Proudly in the gathering of angels.
Subhanallah, subhanallah, subhanallah.
The significance of such a gathering in which you gather, praise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and thank Him Bishop. For sending Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, for blessing us with Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. This could either be in the form of the milad of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Obviously, of course, the Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was born into this dunya. And the day that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was born, everything else comes way afterwards. The Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam spread Islam. We benefited through Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. That all happened after the birth of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So first of all, we thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for sending Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in this dunya. And then thereafter, blessing us with Iman to Rasulullah
sallallahu alayhi wa sallam.
Subhanallah. And we see that Imam Ahmad Ridha Khan
radiallahu ta'ala subhanallah.
Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has said wa rafa'na laka dhikra.
Subhanallah.
He has elevated your remembrance.
Subhanallah.
And He is the one who wishes for your remembrance to be elevated.
Subhanallah.
And your remembrance to be done in the best of the ways.
Subhanallah.
And who are you to try to decrease the remembrance of Rasulullah?
Allah subhanallah.
Belittle the remembrance of Rasulullah.
Subhanallah. Sallallahu ta'ala. Subhanallah.
And this